to the Steam Channel. There is a lot of talk that the live steam and large-scale railroading hobby is dying. With Little Engine suspending its operations recently, one might start to believe this conjecture. But don't fret! Today we are going to discuss four reasons hobbyists should be optimistic about the future of the live steam and large-scale railroading hobby, and offer two ways we can keep our hobby growing. We do want to clarify that we are not nostalgically lamenting over how these things used to be in the good old days, but discussing the contemporary hobby and its future. Over the years, live steam and large-scale railroading has been experiencing a change in the demographic makeup of the hobby. In yesteryears, most hobbyists were tool and die makers, machinists, boiler makers, and were employed in another highly skilled trade. Those who were not from the skilled trades were typically white-collar workers who self-taught themselves these needed skills. This old guard took great pride in building everything themselves, and most would consider it a blight to their honor to go out and purchase something, often being anything above drawings or rough castings. With changes and innovations in our economy over the last 30 to 40 years, these types of skilled tradesmen are not as prolific as they used to be in general. These trades also are not being adequately promoted in public schools, which has led to a further decrease in the number of people going into them. In the last 10 to 15 years or so, increasing numbers of hobbyists are coming from other backgrounds. We know lawyers, doctors, police officers, retail workers, mechanical engineers, and so many other people from diverse backgrounds who have gotten involved with live steam and large-scale railroading. This change in guard has brought a reduction in the number of experienced machinists in the hobby, but it also has brought in new hobbyists with a different approach, skill set, and attitudes on how to do things. More hobbyists are less inclined to scratch build equipment, which has created a market for suppliers and vendors seeking to capitalize on this shifting market. There are many new vendors that have done the design work on rolling stock kits and other components to save the end consumer time. As such, hobbyists now currently have access to the widest catalog of drawings, parts, equipment kits, and castings that have ever been available in the large-scale railroading hobby. Pacific Design Shops, for instance, offers CNC cut wood reefer kits and excellent instructions that almost anyone could use to build a fine-scale model with little to no experience. These kits are made tab and groove, so no special skills are needed to start a build. But you will certainly develop new skills and techniques which can be applied to your next project. These simplified options encourage a wider swath of people to take a shot at building a piece of equipment. Manufacturing technology has advanced considerably in the last few decades, and this has offered more efficient options to produce parts and components. From CNC mills and lathes, water jet cutting, 3D printing and prototyping, Tinkercad, SolidWorks, and Shapeways, hobbyists have so many new tools at their disposal to aid in the construction of their dream projects. These innovations can significantly cut down the man hours needed to complete a project and enhance the overall quality of a build. Our Union Pacific auxiliary tender was drawn out in CAD and fully customized for our needs before a single piece of metal was even cut. All the rivet holes in the tender body were laser cut in the panels by the metal supplier, and the body panels were then rolled and contoured by another professional contractor. Hobbyists willing to teach themselves the skills necessary to wield these advanced technologies can create unique creations that may not be commercially offered. This is an opportunity that was not possible for our hobbyist forefathers. Rail equipment is getting more detailed, more scale, and it takes less time to produce it. While few would disagree that the machining and fabrication skills needed to produce steam locomotive models are declining in the hobby overall, newcoming hobbyists are bringing interest in a wider array of equipment beyond the old steam iron ponies that were once the gold standard. Understandably so, as many younger hobbyists have little to no experiences with steam locomotives outside of preservation. Many contemporary rail fans have shown more interest in diesels and electrics as younger people have grown up watching this equipment in operation. Diesel and electric locomotives are also much more affordable to the entry-level hobbyist. Most of the newly constructed equipment, whether built commercially or in-home shop, is now non-steam. That is not to say younger people are not interested in steam. There are plenty of younger steam enthusiasts in the hobby who are teaching themselves the skills necessary to build and maintain live steam locomotives. Not only have modeling tastes changed, but the younger hobbyists are bringing new ideas to the hobby. Years ago, many in the large-scale railroading hobby treated the hobby tracks as a private country club and took great strides to keep away the public. Kids especially. Some were concerned about liability issues, but others just did not want to be bothered by outsiders. This mindset has shifted somewhat in the contemporary hobby, and an increasing number of organizations are more open to holding public run days or hosting school field trips at their railroads. There are still significant liability issues in hauling the public, so we do not expect all clubs to open their grounds to the public, but the overall increase in the willingness to pull the public in is an encouraging sign. This exposes new people to the hobby and can be a great opportunity to hook new members into large-scale railroading. The isolationists also fail to appreciate that keeping younger folks away from the hobby means it is very likely that the equipment they spent so much time building will likely wind up in an estate sale or a storage unit as they age and die off. The large-scale end of the railroading hobby was not well known in years past. With the rise in social media, hobbyists from all around the world, including us, have brought this hobby to the mainstream. Millions of people have watched our live steam videos and content created by other creators. There is no disputing that social media has brought the large-scale railroading hobby into the limelight. More people than ever are being exposed to our niche through YouTube, Facebook, and other online forums. We can only hope that this exposure leads more people who are interested in large-scale railroading to join our ranks. This is an aging hobby, and we need younger blood to keep this great hobby going. So what can we do to help ensure new folks stay in the live steam and large-scale hobby? First, we need to be willing to share our experience and techniques with other hobbyists. If you are a welder, try to pass on some of your skills to those around you. We believe in knowledge sharing and mentoring wholeheartedly, which is why we take the time to make detailed how-to build videos for all our equipment builds. We also write build articles on these builds, which link the kits, parts, and other supplies used in each build. At the end of the day, the single greatest thing we can do to keep this hobby strong and growing is to be friendly to one another, especially newcomers. It is critical to maintain a friendly, positive, and welcoming culture in your railroad circle or organization. Nothing turns people off faster than clicky organizations or negative Nancy rivet counters. The old guard should stop with the ageist tropes that young people are not interested in trains because of video games, cell phones, etc. Few want to stay around those types of people, and this can cause organizational decay over time. At the end of the day, this is a hobby, and everyone is going to enjoy it differently with different priorities and focuses. There's nothing wrong with that. We are all here to have fun and relax. We believe the live steam and large-scale railroading hobby is strong and has a bright future if new hobbyists continue to get involved. Roll up your sleeves, get involved, and build something cool that you can enjoy. Thanks for hanging out with us here on the Steam Channel. We'll catch you on the rails.
Thanks for tuning in for this video here on the Steam Channel. We hope you enjoyed it. Why not climb aboard for another high-quality steam video in beautiful Ultra HD by clicking on one of the previews to your right?